An overreactive immune response can lead to unchecked inflammation and even autoimmune diseases. Immune checkpoints can prevent these scenarios by regulating the length of the immune response. A prominent immune checkpoint involves the CTLA-4 protein, which operates early in the immune response and acts as a brake on the T cell activation. During the primary signal, the T cell receptor may interact excessively with the antigen MHC complex. When this occurs, CTLA-4 proteins are brought up to the surface of the T cell. Once there, CTLA-4 interferes with the reception of the secondary signal, outcompeting the T cell's CD28 for B7 proteins on the dendritic cell. CTLA-4 binding of B7 counteracts the stimulatory primary signal, halting full T cell activation and reducing proliferation. Another important immune checkpoint is the programmed cell death, or PD-1/PDL-1 pathway, which operates later in the immune response during killer T cell action. Active killer T cells express a downregulation receptor called programmed cell death protein 1, or PD-1, which acts like an off switch when PD-1 on the surface of the killer's T cell binds to its complementary programmed cell death protein ligand, or PDL-1. In healthy cells, PDL-1 expression is an important mechanism for preventing autoimmune damage to the peripheral tissues. Unfortunately, cancer cells take advantage of this regulatory pathway by expressing PDL-1. The resulting interaction between PD-1 and PDL-1 can deactivate the T cell. Once the cancer cells evade immunity, they become tumors. Tumors can migrate in a process known as metastasis. Once tumors metastasize, they can become very difficult to treat with standard chemotherapy. New approaches to cancer treatment with monoclonal antibodies that inhibit immune checkpoints are revolutionizing treatments of individuals with tumors and metastases. These monoclonal antibodies are designed in the lab, manufactured in large quantities, purified, and then administered to the patient during treatment. When we block CTLA-4 using monoclonal antibodies, the T cell's CD28 proteins can freely bind to the dendritic cell's B7 proteins, allowing transduction of the activation signal. When we do the same to the PD-1/PDL-1 checkpoint, the killer T cell remains activated and can proceed to destroy the tumor cell. Monoclonal antibody cocktails that inhibit both checkpoints at once have also proven effective, demonstrating the versatility of immune checkpoint therapy.